It's impossible to do an episode about Uranus without opening up the back door to a spitstorm of potty humor. I get it. There's something just hilarious about talking about your, mine, and everyone's anus. And even if you get to use the more sanitized and sterile term Uranus, it's still pretty dirty in an unwashed New York stairwell kind of way. You're in us? No. Okay, this is a no-win situation. It is a Kobayashi Maru scenario here. We are all doomed. Can we call a truce? I dare you, commentators, to keep the YouTube comments as pure and clean as driven snow, so we can focus on the super interesting science. Think of the children. Okay, let's set the stage. I'm gonna let planetary astronomer Kevin Grazier give you the proper pronunciation to clear our minds and let us move forward with grace and civility.
Strictly speaking, it's pronounced Uranus, is the pronunciation.
As you probably know, Uranus, I mean, Uranus. No, I can't do it. My brainwashing is too far along. Save yourselves! Anyway, Uranus is the seventh planet from the sun and the third largest planet in the solar system. Jupiter and Saturn get all the spacecraft and Hubble Space Telescope time, but Uranus is an incredibly worthwhile target to visit. It's almost exactly four times larger than Earth and has its own set of strange, dusty rings, perhaps left over from a shattered moon. It has at least 27 moons that we know of, and many more interesting features that would fascinate astronomers if we had a spacecraft there, which we don't, which is ridiculous. We've only made one close flyby of Uranus by Voyager 2 back in 1986. We've seen Pluto up close, but there are no plans to visit Uranus. Madness. Anyway, perhaps one of the strangest aspects of Uranus is its tilt. The planet is flipped over on its side like a weeble that wouldn't unwobble. Actually, all the planets in the solar system have some level of axial tilt. The Earth is tilted 23.5 degrees away from the sun's equator, Mars is 25 degrees, and even Mercury is 2.1 degrees tilted. These tilts are everywhere. But Uranus is 97.8 degrees. That's just 0.2 degrees shy of a 90s boy band. Now you might be wondering, why have it been more than 90 degrees? High school geometry tells me that 97.8 degrees is the same as 82.2 degrees, and that's true. But astronomers define the angle as greater than 90 degrees when you take its direction of rotation into account. So when you describe it as turning in the same direction as the rest of the planets in the solar system, then you have to measure it this way. Now, what could have done that to Uranus, and how could it have happened? The fact that Uranus is flipped over on its side tells us that the calm, clockwork motion of the solar system hasn't always been this way. Shortly after the formation of the sun and planets, our neighborhood was a violent place. The early planets smashed into each other, pushed one another into new orbits. Some planets could have been spun out of the solar system entirely, while others might have been driven into the sun. Our own moon was likely formed when a Mars-sized object crashed into the Earth. Other moons might have been captured from three-body interactions between worlds. It was mayhem. The solar system that you see today contains the survivors, everything that wasn't delivered, a death blow. And something really tried to deliver a death blow to Uranus very early after it formed. We know this because the moons of Uranus orbit at the same tilt as the planet's axis. This means that something smashed into Uranus while it was still surrounded by this disk of gas and dust that the moons formed from. When the massive collision happened, the planet flipped over, wrenching this disk with it. The moons formed within this new configuration. Astronomers think it was more complicated than that, however. If it was a single massive collision, models suggest the planet would just flip over entirely and end up rotating backwards from the other planets in the solar system. It's more likely that another collision, or even a series of collisions, put the brakes on Uranus' end-over-end roll, putting it into its current configuration. It boggles the mind to think about what must have happened. Having such a huge axial tilt makes a big difference to Uranus as it travels around the Sun in its 84-year orbit. The planet still has its poles pointed at fixed locations in space. This means that it spends 42 years with its northern hemisphere roughly pointed towards the sun, and 42 years with its southern hemisphere in sunlight. If you could stand on the north pole of Uranus, the sun would be directly overhead in the middle of summer. And then it would make bigger and bigger circles until it dipped below the horizon a few decades later. and then you wouldn't see it for a few decades until it finally reappeared again. It would be very, very strange. Of course, it's a gas planet, and you can't stand on it. And if you could stand on it, we'd all be marveling at your ability to stand on planets. So here we are in our calm, ordered solar system. Everything's business as usual. But if you look around, you realize it's pretty amazing that our planet is even here. Poor sideways Uranus is a testament to our good luck. Now, we love talking about the solar system. What other worlds would you like us to investigate? In our next episode, we study another bizarre kind of star, the magnetar. Oh, and make sure you stick around for the blooper. Once again, we've reached the end of a video. This is the part where I encourage you to join our Patreon community. But if you're feeling like that's too much commitment, then what about sharing this video on your social medias? Help us get the word out and build our subscriber base. Give it a thumbs up, recommend the show to your friends. Every little bit helps. But if you do want to take your support to the next level, consider joining our Patreon community. You'll get advanced access to our videos, see behind the scenes and embarrassing blooper reels, and see no ads on Universe Today. Right now, we've got 563 amazing patrons supporting the work we do. And we'd like to thank Garrett Claiborne, Janos Kurikas, Amir Mohammed, Judge Wood, James Ruben Sutton, and the rest of the members who support us in making great space, astronomy content. Want to get in the action? Go to patreon.com/universetoday. I'll use this rock as a prop. So here's Mercury, and then here's Earth, and here's 90 degrees, and here's a little more, 97.8 degrees.